16, namely the cURL options in the insert from URL script step. It's a pretty cool update as it allows you to do a lot of things natively in FileMaker that you couldn't do before. What's really cool about that is that FileMaker Go users, custom web publishing, WebDirect even, will be able to use this functionality to interact with other websites and services and servers across the web and your local network as well to update information, delete information, or what have you. So here, this is Mason's app that he built a little while ago as an introduction to RESTful APIs. So we have updated this so that it uses the native insert from URL script step instead of the base elements plugin. So everything that you can do now, create users, read users, update, and delete users, you can now do natively. So in this example, we're going to create a user real quick. So the NFL draft is in a couple weeks, and one of the best safeties in the draft is Jamal Adams from LSU. So I'm going to add him and post it. So here we got a response right away, and we also got response headers. This is important because it tells us right away at the top here that 201 created. That means that the record was created, and as you can see over here in the web viewer, the record was created. So we got a nice little response here too, and all of this was done natively. So if we take a look at the script, we see that we're setting the URL here, and then the insert from URL script is where all the action happens. So a couple of updates here. The target you can now specify as both, or not both, but either a field or a variable. So before it was just a field, so you would have to make generally a global field and just kind of use that to pull in the response. But now you can just use a variable and continue on that way. And down here, this new specify cURL options is the new thing. So here, quick breakdown. The X is the request and the post is the kind of request that we're sending. The D says that we want to dump a header, and the variable is the variable that we're going to dump the header into. So you can create the variable right in the calc, which is pretty cool, all in the single step. And then the header, we want to specify the kind of header that we're setting, that we're sending, and that's the specific type of header that we're sending. So if we run through the step and debug it real quick, you can see that, oops, we'll refresh that. So we'll do another NFL prospect, Miles Garrett. So we'll post that up, and we go through and see the URL that we're sending. So this is how you send the info, sometimes, not all the time. So you can see Miles Garrett is in here. So if we continue on, it posts right away. So we get the response code here, so Miles Garrett, and then the HTTP header response here. There are a lot more options that you can do, which I specify more in the article. There's a link to FileMaker's Help where you can get more info on it. But that's the basic gist. But so you can imagine the power that you have here to be able to do a lot of different things. So mobile users will be able to create records in other databases, wherever they may be, delete records, update, web direct, custom web publishing, all that stuff, all natively within FileMaker. Pretty cool. Thanks for watching.